Hi, I'm gonna do this talk in English because I don't speak French, sorry. Okay. If anything can go wrong, it will. It's a universal law that everyone is used to handle during the life, okay? Films, comics, books, video games teach us that disaster is something that strikes when no one is expecting it and is impossible to be ready. No one knows how to face the disaster, and the natural reaction behind the disaster is panic. Heroes or superheroes, it depends on how you want to see it, are those people that have skill and a level head to step up and control the situation. So, superheroes save the world because they are prepared. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Iron Man. No, okay. I'm Giulio Calacoci, I'm a developer for Second Quadrant Italia, and I'm going to talk about barman and disaster recovery. Failure is always an option. This is just like the first one, like the Murphy's Law. It's something you have to care and to take care. Definition of disaster is something that happened unexpectedly, but most important of all is a complete failure, a complete and terrible failure. There are some traits that are common in all kinds of disaster, unexpected, have many forms. They used to create panic and are source of economic and damage if not managed correctly. There are different categories of disaster: a human error, hardware failure, hacking, a bug in the software, or probably the domino effect. Domino effect is something a lot of problems are not able to see. Okay, that when the first tile falls down, all the other problems show up, and the situation is a disaster in the end. The hero, okay, is the one that have to handle the bad situation, a disaster situation. So have to be prepared mentally, have to have the technical, the skill technical, and know about disaster recovery, and not only in the IT world, but everywhere disaster recovery, and have to be well equipped using reliable instruments. Disaster recovery in the IT world is a set of policies and procedures that enable the recovery of a situation and return to the normality. This is the definition taken from Wikipedia. There are two things important when we are talking about disaster recovery. The first one is a recovery point objective. It is recovery point objective, the maximum amount of data that you are prepared to lose in a case of a disaster. It could be zero, okay, but basically is the time that you have between when the data is produced and the data is secure. This is the data you're gonna lose when a disaster strike. And there is the RTO, the recovery time objective, that basically is the maximum downtime you can handle, okay? When we're talking about disaster, we must know how to handle a disaster, and the solution is a disaster recovery plan. There are common misunderstandings about the disaster recovery plan. It's expensive, and I can tell you, yes, it's expensive, but it's more expensive if you are down, you are not prepared, and your competitors are available for your customers. It's a biggest expense for you. And the same is for hardware software requirements. It used to be a cost in the beginning, because you probably have to build redundancy, have more servers, but it's a gain in the long term. Or it's something you don't have to care about. This is just another common misunderstanding, because, for example, Symantec have done a pool and discovered that 50% of small, medium business does not have disaster recovery plan. And this is a huge part of the business. And you have to know that the 47% of this 5% will never recover after a disaster. So it's important to be prepared. A disaster recovery plan must take care about cost and risk, obviously, must be always updated. A plan that had been done 10 years ago is not anymore something useful. And have to be tested. And this is, I can never stress enough this last part. You have to test your disaster recovery plan. Because a plan is worthless if no one knows it. If have not been tested, and you think that reading the manual when the disaster strike is the solution, you are gonna have a really bad moment when the disaster strike. Good disaster recovery plan must take care of redundancy. Okay, only one server maybe is not a solution. You should have something more. Monitoring, backups, obviously. And the backups have to be automated, frequent, and always available. And of recovery. When you have a recovery, you have to test it, because there is a law of the Schrödinger backup. If you don't test the backup, you don't know if the backup is going to work or not. Disaster and databases. Databases is the core of every business, and disaster are always ready to strike. There are two types of backups when we talk about databases, especially Postgres. There are logical backups and physical backups. The logical ones are done with SQL file, usually are slow, and talking about Postgres are based on pgdump and pgrestore tools. The physical backup are based on the copy of the PG data, okay? And usually is faster than the logical backup. There are a lot of disaster recovery tools. This is a list, okay? There are a lot of programs that can help you in doing this, but there is also Barman. Barman is the disaster backup and recovery manager for Postgres. It's developed by Second Quadrant Italia. And now, just now, because we have released the beta version today, I've reached the 2.0 version, because we have introduced a lot of changes that we are going to see in a bit. So we changed the measured version. Barman is based on integration, usability, automation, reliability, robustness. It's something you want from a tool that you're going to use during a disaster, okay? Especially the reliability and robustness. This is the core team, the dream team that write Barman, and you can see me and Giuseppe that is here, okay? And we develop Barman using DevOps, and this is our Kanban board that we use to manage all the tasks that we have to do when we have to introduce a new feature for Barman. Just a quick introduction to Barman. Is written in Python and works with Python 2.6 or more. Works on Linux, and we provide packages for Debian and for NRPM packages. Works with PostgreSQL 8.3 or more, or greater. Based on SSH, rsync, PG-based backup, and PG-civics log. Barman handles only physical backups. So if you want only a logical backup, this is not the tool for you. But if you want only logical backup, maybe you have to think about it. Not because you have to use Barman, but because physical backups are more reliable. Physical backup, and we take care about full backup during a base backup, or differential backup handling and archiving the whole files, incremental backup that is based on rsync and uses hard links to reuse unchanged files. And as I said, there is no support for logical backup. And a backup done by Barman is a backup of a full cluster of your Postgres, not only a single database. These are some scenarios where Barman could be useful. Let's start for the first one. It's more simple. It's something that I have been asked about a lot of times in the Barman mailing list and also in person. Can I use Barman in the same server where my Postgres is located? Yes, but it's a failure. It's a failure because everything that is going to strike on your server, for example, hardware failure, is going to hit your database and your backups. It's not a good idea. You want the backup to be far, very, very far from the disaster when it's happening. So this is no. You don't want to do that. So the minimal solution is this one. You have a master, a server, Postgres server, and a backup server. This is a solution I have really, really low RPO, so you are not going to lose a lot of data, probably nothing. But it requires a lot of time, because you have to, when the disaster strikes, you have to recover the master server, then you have to copy the backup and then restart the server. So there is a bit of time and you require to restart everything. Subsequently, the first option is a lot of masters and one backup server, because Barman can handle multiple servers. Then this is a single point of failure, and we know that. But if you can gather all the failures in only one point, you monitor it, you are aware where something happens. And if Barman fails, it's not a major failure, because your servers are always online. You're going to lose the backup, but you can take new backups. So this is a solution that is solid. The evolution is a basic disaster recovery solution. It's based on a PostgreSQL server, a Barman server, and a server that is here waiting for the disaster to happen. Okay, it's not it do anything, but you can use it to recover instantly when the master falls down. So you have a lowest RTO, because you don't have to reinstall probably the master, but you can use the spare server to restart a new session and use it as a new master. But the most used, the most clever solution is this one. You have a master and a standby, so you have a high availability, and you have Barman that is backing up, and you can do backups from the master or the standby. So you have, like doing this, you have low RPO and low RTO. This is the optimal solution and the most clever one. Barman. I said before, 2.0. Because 2.0, and probably is going to be released the 27th of this month, so near. The beta have been released today, and you can find it on the website of Barman. And we have changed the merger, because in the 1.6.0 we introduced the support for PGA Civic slot. So before that, we used to rely on the archive command to receive your world file and archive them. From the 1.6.0, we have added PGA Civic slot, so we support the streaming technology from Postgres. 2.0, we have added support for replication slots, support for synchronous streaming, and backup method Postgres that is based on PG-based backup. This means that with both PGA Civic slot and PG-based backup, we are going to have RPO zero, not almost zero like before, zero. And this is huge, because when the data is written on Postgres, it's also written on your Barman server. So one-to-one, you are going to lose zero data. Using this structure, you can have a standby server and a Barman that is synchronous streaming like the server and acts like a server. Obviously, you cannot perform queries on your database server, but usually, if without this node, if the standby server crash, the master server is going to stop, because it cannot write on the standby. With this method, you can. The synchronous streaming will write on the backup server, and the master server will be available always. And when you recover the standby, you can use the restore command asking for Barman for the worlds that you have lost. So you're going to recover the time you have lost. So RPO zero, for the master and the standby. And using PG Civics log and PG base backup, we have support for Windows and Docker. So far, Barman and most of the tools that we use for recovery and backup on Postgres are working only on Unix, for Unix server. Using this technology, we can backup Windows machine and Docker machine without any effort, without changing anything. These are features that we always have had in Barman, but still here, like a backup catalog. We store the backup and we handle it. Okay, so in every moment you know how many backups you have, how many terabytes, gigabytes, or megabytes of wall associated to your backup you have. So always the situation of your backup server for server is clear. We do incremental backup and incremental recovery, because if you think about it, a huge portion of files is not modified between each backup if you're going to copy the data dir. So if you can identify only the files that need to be copied because have been modified, you're going to gain a lot of time and a lot of space on the disk. And we use hard links from the previous version of the same backup. And we're going to save from 50 to 70% this space on your backup server and on your network traffic. This is wall archiving. Barman takes care of your wall files. I've said before the introduction of the PG Recipix log, we used to rely only on the archive command to send the wall files to the Barman server. And then Barman, with a cron command, used to read the wall files in the incoming directory and compress them if needed and archive them in a special directory when he can access. And he knows every wall file to which backup belong. So everything is handled internally. We have added also the streaming archiver that adds another directory that takes care of the streaming with the streaming archiver, and you can use both the archiving system or only one of those right now. And the wool files are also archived like before. So everything is stored and everything is saved. You can consider when, talking about RPO, when your data is safe, when it's archived by Barman. This is the moment where your RPO is zero. When it's archived, you're going to lose anything. And the get wall is the system that I was talking about before that allows you to recover a standby, because Barman can be used like a wall hub. Okay, so the Postgres, the standby server, can ask using the restore command for the walls that is missing, and it can recover faster than asking to Postgres, and probably Postgres could not have the walls that the standby need. In this case, you would have to rebuild the standby server. Using Barman, you don't need to. You just ask for Barman for the walls that you're missing. So it's faster and reliable and safer. Other functionalities are obviously point-in-time recovery, monitoring, bandwidth limit when you're copying things, network compression, attention policies that are based on redundancy, that you want a number of backups before deleting the oldest one, or recovery window based on time. Okay, 2 weeks worth of backups. Okay. You can do backup from a standby server using PG Espresso for 9.2 to 9.5, or right now we have the support for 9.6 and obviously newest version that will come in the future. So it supports natively the new API for backup. And we have also hook scripts that allow you to do action pre and post backup and pre and post archiving of a wall file or a backup, and retry hook script that do the same but will retry until success. We'll never stop to retry until success. The evolution, okay, well, what we want to do, or our wish list for Barman in the next month, this is the roadmap. Okay, we are already working on the parallel backup because we want rsync to work with multiple processes, because right now we use only one process to copy. And we have tried that. There is also a proof of concept around and been tested by one of our clients, we reached 500 megabytes per second on the network, so it's good with four processes copying. Technically, it's easy. This is the data deal. We're going to split in portion the files and copying using multiple processes. And the page level incremental backup. This is okay. When the data is modified, there is a page that is written in Postgres inside your files that are in your data directory. We can only copy the page that is 8K of dimension that have been modified. Only the pages that have been modified. And we are going to gain a lot of space and time and network traffic doing that, something like that. It's something we are working on. We have a partnership with a group of Russian people that want to work with us. We're going to release something in the near future. Right now, it's something we are not prepared to show to the world, but we are working on it. But it's something in the near future we are going to release. But we would like to add process manager because Barman has a lot of sub-processes like rsync, like PG Civics Lock, like PG Base Backup. We want to add a management of the processes inside Barman without using external tools like PS or things like that to manage the sub-processes. We want to add support for S3 storage, support for TAR storage, backup compression, and for who thinks that security is never enough, backup encryption. We want to add a management of import and export of the backups from the catalog of Barman is something right now we have difficult to handle, especially if the backup have been removed from the catalog, is too old and is over the recovery window. And finally, we would like to add geographic redundancy, backup scheduling, and the backup strategy of grandfather, father, son. In conclusion, to be the true hero, you have to feel a true hero when you do stuff like this, because you are the hero of the data, okay? The true hero, when the disaster strikes, you need to have a plan known by everyone. This is the most important part, probably. Use reliable tools and know how to use them. Test, simulate regularly, because practice makes perfect. Doing so, you are going to be the hero that is saved the world because you are prepared. Thank you.